positions. Staying on top of your positions and performance is imperative for every trader. In this video, I'll navigate you through the positions widget in Robinhood Legend, our brand new browser-based trading platform. We'll explore how your positions are displayed, how to customize and group them, and most importantly, how to manage and close your positions. Let's get started. All right, staring at a blank layout here on Robinhood Legend. I've named the layout positions, and we're gonna click add widget and add positions to our layout. Now, immediately you'll see the widget has been added, but there's a lot of data being cut off. So the first thing we're gonna do is resize it. Just like any widget in Robinhood Legend, we could grab the side, the corner, the bottom, and reposition as we see fit. I'm gonna grab the corner there, and let's drag this out so that we see all of the data currently in our positions widget. Now, before we dive in and do any customization, let's do a quick tour of the widget. In the upper left-hand corner, we have our linking group square. So if we had other widgets on the screen, we could link this to watch lists, charts, or orders. To the right of that, we have the search functionality. So here we have a lot of positions in this account. Maybe you have so many positions that you want to quickly find one. So for example, we could search by a stock symbol. I'm just gonna type Microsoft because I know we have a position in this account. Click on that with our mouse or keyboard. And there you see we've filtered this entire position list to just Microsoft, which currently we have one share of that stock. If we wanna get rid of that and see the original list, we'll click the X here in the tab. And now we've gone back to the original state where we can see all of our positions listed in the account. Over on the right-hand side, similar to the recent orders widget, we have a filter button. So if we want to filter positions out by different criteria, we click on that. And here we can filter based on asset type. So for example, right now we're showing all positions, whether stocks or options. If we just want to see equity positions, so stocks or ETFs, that's going to filter right away to that. If we want to filter by options position, a simple click of the mouse button. And now we're just seeing all the options in this account. We can also filter even more here based on days to expiration. So maybe I want to see positions that are just less than 7 days to expiration. Right now we have none of those in the account. Let's go to 10, let's go to less than 30, and there you see our position. So in this particular account, we have no expiration dates less than 10 days. So just keep that in mind. Sometimes you'll get a filter result that gives you a null value because you might not have something that fits that criteria. If we want to revert back to the default state, we'll click clear. And now we see all equities positions, all options positions, no filters for expiration date. We're back to where we started. Click done. To the right of that, we have our three-dot settings menu. Here's where we can group our positions. We can customize columns as well as delete the widget. Let's start by looking at the group by. So what is group by? Well, this allows us to group positions based on different criteria. If you notice currently, everything is just listed out no matter what the type of position is. So here we have an Apple stock position, an Apple options position. Below here, we have JP Morgan with just options mixed in with stock and options position in one long list. But most traders, including myself, I like to group positions based on the underlying stock. So it kind of keeps everything into a nice group or family that I can easily navigate and manage my positions. So let's do that. Let's group by underlying. And you'll notice this list has now condensed, it's collapsed. And there's a few carats to the left of some of these symbols. So this is gonna be where we have a position where either there's options within that collapsed area or stock and options. So for example, in our account, in this Apple position, if we open this up, you'll see that we have both a stock position, we have two shares of Apple. We also own this Apple October 25th 250 call. So by grouping these together by underlying, I can quickly do position management based on what's happening within Apple overall as a group. Now, if I want to condense and close that up, I do that simply by clicking the caret once more. Now you can also group by asset type. So when we do this, it's now going to break things down into all of our equities positions and all of our options positions. Once again, this is a personal preference. It's up to you on how you want to group this. But if we click open the caret for equities, now it's listing all of our stock positions for these different underlying symbols. If I open options, same thing. It's going to list this alphabetically by options position. So you can see Apple, JPM, Tesla, Walmart. That's all sorted alphabetically. And then we would have to sort of pick and choose options that we want to manage based on this grouping. Now let's go back to the group by menu and let's add show multi-leg groups. Now what this does is if you have a position on, say an options position that is a multi-leg position, it's gonna group by that spread that you originally opened. So if we go into our options position, you can see now there's a little bit more organization happening under each of these different options positions. So for example, the JP Morgan position, this is a call debit spread that was opened up where we bought the 210 call, sold the 215 call in one order, and that is considered an option strategy or a grouping. So this is just, once again, a more visual way to see your positions, manage them accordingly, but also too, when we get to trading or managing a position like this, grouping by multi-leg group allows you to close this position as one group so we don't have to build the order with each individual options leg. We'll show you how to do that later in the video. All right, let's go back to the original state. We're just gonna group by none for now and we'll get rid of multi-leg groups. The next thing I wanna show you is how to customize the data points that you see on this widget. By default, there's a ton of data that you're starting with, but there's plenty more that you can add as well. And this is the same as we do with other widgets. We'll click on the settings menu, hover over customize columns, and you'll see that there's a very long list of data points that you can add to this positions widget. Once again, this is personal preference. Find the data points that are important to you that help you navigate this data and make informed decisions. Don't add anything more than you need. Really take some time to learn what each of these metrics mean and figure out if it's useful to you. For now, let's add a few. We're gonna add the bid and ask, and let's just add some of our option Greeks because we know we have some options positions in this account. You'll notice as I'm adding these data points, this list is getting longer, but because of our widget is condensed in terms of its size, it's now creating an opportunity for us to view this by scrolling our mouse left and right. And so we keep the layout in the same position and sizing, but we've added more data to it, which allows us to take advantage of the different data points that are available in Legend. Now, if we wanted to resize the layout, we absolutely could. We can grab the corner of this, move this all the way over. If you wanted to make an entire screen just for positions, we could do that. And if you wanted to just keep some space open for some other widgets, you could do that as well. It's totally up to you. That's the beauty of Robinhood Legend and how you can organize, sort, and create different customizable layouts. If you want to sort this data by any specific column, you can simply click the mouse at the top of the column header. So maybe, for example, we want to sort by which positions are up the most, which positions are down the most. I can click the column header. It's now put my most profitable positions at the top of the screen and my least profitable at the bottom. If I want to flip that order, I just click it one more time. And now we're sorting by the least profitable position in our account where the most profitable is at the bottom. We want to revert back to symbol sorting. Just click on symbol. And now we're back to that alphabetical list. All right, so what I've done, I've created a two monitor layout. On my left monitor, I've got my account summary, watch list, recent orders, and then down below here in this bottom half portion of the screen is our positions widget. Over on the right monitor, we have a full monitor dedicated to our charts. Now, one thing I want to point out, I've linked all of these widgets together using the linking group feature. You can see that by the orange square in the upper left-hand corner of each of these widgets. So what that does is it allows me to navigate quickly through a watch list of symbols. So for example, if I were to click on AMC, it's gonna change the positions that I see on my screen. We have no orders in AMC, we have no positions in AMC, but the chart has changed. And if we keep scrolling through our watch list, here's an example, Amazon, we do have orders, we do have a position, and the chart changes as well. Now, if you do not want your orders or positions widgets, or any widget for that matter, linked to different ones, you can always ungroup them. So for example, we can ungroup our positions widget and just select unlinked. And I'm gonna do the same thing for our orders. And let's get rid of the Amazon filter there. And now you can see that our orders and position widgets are back to the default state where we see all of our orders and positions and all the information that goes with it. And as I scroll through my watch list, you'll notice that the chart is updating on the right monitor, but orders and positions is not. So this is a way as a trader to dynamically move through a watch list on certain widgets on your layout, but keep some static, which for orders and positions may be something you want to do. Now, last but certainly not least, we can trade from the positions widget. In fact, you'll probably trade a lot from there. If you think about it, as you have positions and have to do position management, this is, in my opinion, the best place to go to create orders to exit positions. You could always create an opposite position just using an order ticket or the option chain, but for an accuracy standpoint, it's usually best if you're looking to get out of a position, queue up your order from the positions widget so it does it the correct underlying symbol, quantity, action. So let me show you what I mean by that. So in this account, we have a few positions. Let's start with a simple stock position. We have 5 shares of Ford in the account. Maybe we want to close this position. We can do that once again by just queuing up an order to sell 5 shares of Ford. Or when we hover our mouse over this line of data, you'll see a button appear that says close. When I do that, an order will automatically populate with the correct amount of shares and the correct action. So I'm selling 5 shares of Ford, which is the position that we currently have in the account. Now, just like any order, we can choose the type of order we want to place here. Maybe we want to sell 5 shares at the current market price. Maybe we want to work a limit order. It's totally up to you on what you want to do. For this example, let's work an order to sell these shares at $15 a share, and we'll work that limit good till canceled. So now I have an order to sell shares if the stock goes up, and we'll click sell. And there we've got to confirm that our limit order to sell 5 shares of Ford was submitted. And there it is up top in our recent orders working order section. Now, the other thing you can do from here is maybe you have a position you want to set a stop order. Let's look at another one of our positions. We have 1 share of Nvidia. Let's put in a sell stop order in case that stock goes down. We want to limit our losses. We can do it just the same. Hover our mouse over that set stop. An order to sell the exact amount of shares in our account is queued up, and it is set to stop market order. So I can do this right now. The stock's trading around 117. Let's put this down. I'm just gonna put a random number, 105. If Nvidia falls to 105, we wanna stop our losses on this position, which remember, stop market orders don't guarantee fills at the exact price of your stop order. What they do is they trigger a market order to sell. So hopefully if this triggers, we get filled at or near the best available bid price. We'll put that order in by clicking sell Nvidia. Now, keep in mind, you always wanna make sure you have your time and force selected. We're gonna change this to good till canceled and hit sell Nvidia. And we have another order confirm that our market order to sell 1 share of Nvidia is working. There it is. It's a stop market at 1, and that is working as intended. Now, what if you just wanted to get out of a position? You can do that as well from the positions widget. Let's select our Microsoft position. We have 1 share of that stock. And when we hover our mouse over close, it's gonna queue up the opposite order. Let's just do this one at the market price. We're gonna sell 1 share of Microsoft at the market and hit the sell button. And there we've got to confirm that our order was submitted and filled. We can see that now in our order section, we have a fill on our Microsoft. And you'll notice Microsoft is no longer listed in our positions widget. It's no longer a position in our account. One other thing I want to point out, and this is a cool feature. If you'll notice that I have a position on Amazon, but when I hover my mouse over there, there's no buttons that are visible. That's not a bug. If you notice, we already have a working order on Amazon up top to sell that. So we can't resell something we already have a working order in. That would end up creating a short position in our account if both of those sell orders were filled. So if you had to do management on this position from the positions widget, we can click the settings menu. And the only thing we can do from this widget is increase this position. If we want to close this, we have to go to this order in our recent orders, and here we can cancel and replace this order, sell it at the market, get rid of it, change the limit price. Whatever you're looking to do, you can do that from the orders widget as opposed to doing it from the positions widget. And finally, let's show you how to close a multi-leg options group from your positions widget. We have a multi-leg position here in JP Morgan, where we are long the 210, 215 call spread. Now you'll notice right now, I don't have an option to close this as a spread. I hover my mouse over each of these individual options leg, and I get the option to close or set a stop on the long call option. So how would I be able to close this as a spread? The first thing I have to do is go back to that settings menu, group by, and multi-leg groups. And notice when I click this button where we see the JPM header at the top of this group, we now see a new header, JPM call debit spread. And I have the option to close this as a group, where before I could only leg out of this position by managing one of the individual options legs of the spread. So to do that, I'm gonna hit close, and now the order ticket has queued up the opposite order of my call debit spread, which is a call credit spread. Once again, this is an important tip. If you're managing positions, it's usually better to do it from the positions widget instead of trying to build this a la carte from the option chain, because you might make a mistake. So here, the order ticket has set up a sell to close on the 210 call, that's the option we own, and a buy to close on the 215 call, that's the option we're short. The quantity is correct. The price is based on the pricing of the spread. So maybe we wanna try to get out of this position. I'm just gonna pick a price near the mark price. We'll go $1.90, and then we're gonna hit submit. And now we have a confirmation our order is working and filled. So notice now our JPM position is no longer listed in our positions widget. It has moved up into our recent orders, and that JPM call credit spread was filled, which has closed the long debit spread that we originally owned, and we're out of the position. And that's the position widget, guys. This is one of the most important widgets that you're gonna have on your screen. So as I've done in this multi-screen layout, you may wanna dedicate a larger portion of one of your screens to this, as well as recent orders, because those are just crucially important pieces of information to help you manage your positions and account throughout the trading day. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe for more tips and tutorials on Robinhood Legend. Have a question? Drop them in the comments. We'd love to hear from you. Happy trading. I'll see you in the next video.